When teams work together, conflict is unavoidable. There will always be different positions, and the conflict, may it be a light conflict or even a real fight, is not avoidable. Now, the question is, how can you anticipate and manage conflict? Hey, my name is Armin L. Rao. I'm the founder of A. Leonard Rao, the entrepreneur's entrepreneur, and I help entrepreneurs to become better leaders. I regularly talk with entrepreneurs' friends and I ask them, hey, what is your biggest challenge right now in terms of leading people and in terms of leading your company? The other day, one of my entrepreneurs' friends said, I would like to know how to anticipate conflict. That is a real challenge for me. Now, this video is about anticipating and managing conflict. Watch it until the end so that you will understand my three steps to conflict management. A conflict, in my definition, is a situation where two or more parties have contradicting intentions. For example, your salespeople want to sell, your product development people want to hold back the product because they think it is not perfect yet. Sales wants the revenue, product development wants to deliver reliable products. A typical conflict. Now, how can we solve this conflict? The first strategy is always to prevent the conflict. And you prevent conflicts by determining the parties that might have the conflict. So in this example, the product development team and the sales team. Then you get them at one table, you clarify upfront the principles, assumptions, and constraints of the project or the cooperation between the two teams, and you get the commitment of the parties to adhere by these rules. So by this, you can prevent conflict before it even arises. Strategy number two is to coordinate. Now, here you have regular meetings with the two teams. Again, in this example, the sales team and the product development team. You discuss the problems openly and you create compromises that help both teams to get ahead. And strategy number three is conflict management. Now, there will always be conflicts that arise, and also in your coordination meetings, these conflicts will be discussed. The trick is to treat them early on so that they do not lead to a crisis and that they do not paralyze the whole company. And in conflict management, it is very important to let both parties, or even three parties, it depends on how many parties are in conflict, describe their position and why they see a problem, so that everybody is on the same page and that everybody understands what the problem really is. You recap your understanding as a leader of the problem, and you make sure by asking the parties if you have understood correctly that you actually have understood the problem correctly. You then create a solution together with the conflicting parties, and you get again their commitment to implement the action plan that you have agreed. Now, these are the three steps to effective conflict anticipation and management: prevent the conflict, coordinate the work between the parties that might have a conflict, and number three, manage the conflict. There's a caveat though. Sometimes one of the parties has to support the other, even though they might not agree at all. Don't make any foul compromises so that everybody feels like they had won something. In some instances, you will have to make a hard decision. It's a moment of truth, and you might be in a position where you say to one of the parties, listen, we are now going to do it the way this other party wants it to do, because I believe bang, bang, bang. At least you have explained why you have taken this decision, and then again you get the commitment. So avoid foul compromises in conflict management. The LIFE program teaches you all the method, tips, tricks, and tools of successful leadership for entrepreneurs within weeks. If you'd like to have more inspiration on leadership for entrepreneurs, register for my mini course by clicking underneath this video on the link so that you get some more insights on successful leadership for entrepreneurs. If you like this content, give us a thumbs up, share it with your community. Also leave a comment. I will reply to every comment I get. And I can only end by saying this was Armin L. Rao from A. Leonard Rao, the entrepreneur's entrepreneur. And don't forget, lead yourself.